Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success, an online free educational institute mainly for engineers. So this video is presented by me, Shishendu Mitra, research scholar of Indian Institute of Technology, Guwahati. So in this video, I am going to teach you a multiphysics COMSOL problem. So this video is specially made for Reflux 2017 organized by Department of Chemical Engineering, IIT Guwahati. So before going into details, let me discuss the problem statement. So here we are going to do a thermal stress of a beam. Suppose there is a beam, say this is the beam. I will be doing it in 3D, but here I am showing it in 2D. Suppose this beam, two walls are kept at different temperatures. Say the bottom wall is kept at say 400 Kelvin and the top wall is kept at say T equal to 100 Kelvin. So we maintain two different temperatures at both the walls of the beam. So because of that, there will be a heat transfer from this portion to that portion. At the same time, because of thermal expansivity of the material, it would deform, and that deformation is caused thermal stress. So how the thermal stress will be acting on inside this beam and how it would deform, that we will be doing by COMSOL simulation. So now we go to COMSOL. This is the COMSOL window. Initially you click on model wizard and you will get several options. Now we will be doing in 3D, that's why I take 3D, click on it. Here you will be getting your physics. Now this problem involves two physics. One is heat transfer because there is a temperature gradient, and other is thermal stress, that is static structure. These two physics combinedly we have to take and we have to solve. Combinedly these two physics is called thermal stress, as I have taken already, so that's why it is shown in recently used item. So you take thermal stress, click on add. It will take some time. Yeah, so you can see now in thermal stress you have basically two physics together. One is solid mechanics that takes care of the beam deformation, and other is heat transfer in solid. Because there is a temperature gradient, so there will be a heat transfer, and that heat transfer will be solving by taking this heat transfer in solids physics. Now these two physics are coupled, and this portion is shown, this portion shows the multiphysics coupling. Now you go to study, click on it and take stationary study and then click on done. Now this is the COMSOL page. You can see here there are several windows or sub windows. This is the model builder section where we build our model. This is the setting where we can change the inputs, and this is the graphics window. Whatever we are doing, we are making a geometry and the simulation is running, everything will be visually shown in this graphics window. Now initially you can see the length is in unit in meter by default. I change it to say centimeter. At the same thing, geometry you can access from here also, but now I will right click on geometry and take a block, say block of width 10 and height and depth 1. Click on build selected. So this block has been created. Now once you are done with your geometry, you have to define the material of this block. Which material is there in this block? So now I go to material, right click on it, then click on add material, go to recently used material. So I have already taken a copper recent material recently. This is a copper material. So this material only I am selecting. So after selecting, click on add to section. So you can see the material has been added. Now you have to choose the portions where you want to choose copper. So the entire material is made of copper. So I choose the entire section. Now few properties are not given here. So you have to define those properties. Just a minute. Let us take once again, go to add material, select this copper, add to selection. Yeah, so these two properties, Young modulus and Poisson ratio, are not given by default. So let us say Young modulus is 180 gigapascal or something like this. So we choose gigapascal and say Poisson ratio is 0.35. That might not be the correct value, but for the simulation purpose we take some value. Now I go to solid mechanics, right click on it and then click on fixed constraint. So this is a beam where two portions are compact, two portions are fixed, so that we have to define. So this end is fixed and the opposite end. So these two portions are fixed, rest of the portions are free. The entire material is linear elastic material. Don't change initial values. Then go to heat transfer, right click on it and take temperature. Again right click on it, take another temperature. So temperature one, say the bottom one. So this portion is kept at say higher temperature, say 400 Kelvin, and the opposite portion, that is this one, say this is kept at 100 Kelvin. Now we have defined our problem properly, then we go to mesh. Physics control mesh is selected by default. We take finer size and then click on build all. This is not good enough. So we take extra fine, again do build all. So mesh has been created. So now we are done with all the formalities, and then we have to go to study and click on compute study. It will take some time to simulate. You can see simulation is going on. Yeah, so simulation over. Now from result section you can go to stress. This is the stress having unit of Newton per meter square. You can see how much stress is acting inside the body, and also you can see the physical deformation. You can see it has deformed a bit. Initially the beam was totally straight. Now it took some curvature because of the thermal stress. So that is what we wanted to show. So this deformation is entirely because of the thermal stress. You can see the temperature profile because there was a temperature gradient. So you can see how the temperature profile looks. So this wall is kept at 100 degree. So this is the minimum temperature. Yellow portion shows you the maximum temperature. As you go from this point to that point, the temperature gradually decreases. This is the isothermal contours. You can see this planes shows same temperature planes. So that was the model related to thermal stress. Please subscribe to my channel. I will be uploading same kind of videos. Thank you very much.